Looks like they wanted me killed and Patty killed. I had a dream where I hovered. I was hovering over a garage where her car was kept for work. It was a dream. It was night. I was hovering over the garage where the car was being worked on. It turned out they were messing up her brakes, so she'd slide down the hill and die either before or after me. They're saying that they had, for the other tenants, they had special tires, rigged special tires, snow chains, I don't know what they had, but they weren't at risk. And they said that for me to see everybody else doing it okay, and everybody else doing it safely, would make me think it was okay, but I just couldn't go down the end of the fucking hill. I just couldn't do it. Because you only have to, idle rolling forward, unable to stop to go into that ravine, go over that little cliff. Anyway, I don't know what I did. I guess I would walk down to the bus stop with Rich or something. I also used to drive him to school and pick him up. I don't know what he was in. He finished kindergarten there and went first and second. And first was at Roosevelt School. Anyways. Look, I was a married woman that did honestly mean something to me. The maintenance man, Mark, I don't know his last name, he had a wife. She's the one that cleaned the apartment before we moved in. And I thought she had done a very good job, and I said something to the manager. Like so many of these males, they think I'm romantic or interested in them, or in need of fucking or something. But I was a married woman, I wasn't that unhappy. Anyway, his wife, the one who had, I don't know if she did it regularly, if she was regular staff at Timber Falls or what. Mark's wife, he was maintenance at Timber Falls in Blakely, Pennsylvania. And his wife had been the one that cleaned our apartment before we moved in. And she had done such a nice job that I said something to the manager that, you know, she really did a nice job. Anyway, I don't know if she did that regularly, if she was regular staff at Timber Falls or not, but she had a brother who just was creepy. He creeped me out. And I think that's who Stephanie was fucking that night. And maybe Mike kicked her out of the house. And maybe her husband, Mike, Air Force, kicked her out of the house. I know that she wanted, well, I'm as sure as I can be, that she wanted to stay at Patty's. She knocked at Patty's door. Some shit had blown up or whatever. Anyway. So, I don't know. It did bother me when I made the jewelry for the girls to give her. And the sob story that I had bought, I bought her sob story. And then it turns out she was lying, and I didn't even know why she had like called to thank me or something for the jewelry. I don't know what it was, but she had lied about everything. And so that's Donna Walden Books, who early on was labeled as traitor for eternity. The guy that was the maintenance man's wife's brother was named Rick, I think. Anyway, he just gave me the creeps. I thought he was pretty fucking creepy. So God was laughing at them because the whole thing comes down to Stephanie Egan, who, you know, I don't know, Stephanie Egan. I didn't like the fact that she lied to me about the jewelry and that I bought the whole sob story. God says I didn't feel mad at myself the way a Bible story is. That I have been manipulated into saying things that aren't true about me. Oh. Yes. I want all the punishments I've asked for. I reaffirm all requests for all Satanists. Affirm, reaffirm to the power of an infinite number of infinities. A. Donna Walden Books, who in my experience was labeled as traitor for eternity, is really Stephanie Egan, who was a German woman that I met when I lived at Timber Falls, when Rich and I lived at Timber Falls. She was German. She told me, Ich bin ein Berliner, was when John F. Kennedy said that he was actually saying, I'm a jelly donut. And I guess in her mind, she had put him down and made him look foolish to me. But the truth is, I figured there's probably a donut called a Berliner in Germany. So he said, I am a Berliner. And he also said, I'm a Berliner, a jelly donut. He probably didn't know what a Berliner was. But anyway, you know, so that's her big thing, traitor for eternity. I don't know. So we got Stephanie Egan, we got Mark the maintenance man at Timber Falls. They're saying that cars were rigged to be able to safely go down that icy hill, and that it was meant for Patty and me both to die going over the knot railing on the other side of the street at the bottom of the hill. But I just wouldn't go down it. I just wouldn't. I couldn't. Mark said, you mean, because he told me, let me handle it, don't call the owner. Because I said something about it, well, I might call the owner or something about it. If he's not allowing you to have the equipment and the supplies you need to clear the driveway. He said, let me handle it. Don't call the owner. Well, nothing changed. Mark didn't do anything. So I called the owner. And he was rude. And it turned out Patty and I went around with a petition to the tenants of Timber Falls, asked them if they wanted a sign about the ice at the bottom of the hill. We got a lot of signatures, and I don't know what came of it. I don't know if anything. I just don't remember how it all worked out. So. Personally, I remember thinking as we were going around different houses, I hope to see houses as messy as mine was. And I didn't. Everybody's house looked pretty nice. So. I just felt like a messy person. So, anyway, that's about it. No, not really that I recall. Piano, the table, the surfaces. I think so. I think it was clothes and mail and blah. No. Rolled it down the hill as far as we could get it. Which was like, bump, bump. Weighed about 5,000 pounds. Too much. Wasn't there another reason? Well, I wasn't trying to hide it. It's trash. Take it apart, it's trash. Well, maybe we didn't have one. Do we have one? Maybe ours was full. Come on, people. Jesus Christ. Well, she's kind of gross. I don't know. Wow. I see. Well, it's up to God. This is His timing. Satanists are humiliated because Stephanie Egan was kind of gross. And she is Donna Walden Books, Traitor for Eternity. She was fucking a gross guy. I guess. Rick. So they're embarrassed. I guess I thought it was different. I wasn't complaining about him that time. again, she was pretty and she was full of personality. Understand. We were more family. And then she had pictures of her mom and all that crap. Not really. That's exactly what I felt. Why aren't there any pictures of us up there? We're more family than they are. You were mad at your mother. You didn't like your mother. That's true. She seemed nice and healthy and all that kind of stuff. So I enjoyed getting to know her in the little conversation we had that day. And the conversation. No. I don't know, Patty. You had changed so much. I don't think I thought about him both together that... No. I don't like mothers. Nah. That's bullshit. I just thought she was nice and... kinda. And I appreciated that. I'm gonna say your mother triggered something of my mother in me for me to be that self-conscious of my appearance. I just couldn't have her see me like that. She did, I think, and she stared at it. And I just couldn't. I think it was, yeah. I guess that's quite possible. No, because I didn't do anything in there. I did everything at the kitchen table. Yes. I looked every time. Everybody was all picked up and nice, and nobody was laying around with blankets over their legs or anything, or newspapers on the floor. I'm looking for stuff like that. Oh. Wait. JFK stuff. So I'm not revising, but I can buy my plain Janes. PJ, PJ. PJ, PJ. But I did. Oh. Uh-oh. Yeah. Plan Jane. There we go. I want to be familiar with you. Thank you. I got free shipping. Right, so I'll choose Walmart. Fuck Amazon. Yeah, I gotta figure all that shit out. It will, won't it? See ya. Fuck that shit. None of it went through. Now I got a Walmart app. No, I don't. I'm on a different phone. Mm-hmm. I don't want you to be a stranger, intimidating or anything. Can I? I wonder, can, I could say, hardly. Holy shit. Frames. Pops, pops, yogurt, yogurt. La 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 la. Sunday. Can I live without it? Sunday. Sunday from 10 to 11. 10 to 4. Okay. Right. Keep my time slot. That's a shitload of money, man. That is one shitload. Mm-hmm. anything. You think I didn't know that, eh? Do you any? Let's see. 1488 times 582, $900 bucks. I didn't shut it off. I can get more. I have to pee. I don't know why you're doing this. It's like, how about this isn't my house? Donna Walden looks so she's ugly. Donna Walden looks so she's ugly. She's gross. Donna Walden looks just really ugly. I'm not gonna say that. Thank you. That was very fun. I'm gonna upload this.